Daniel chapter 6, lesson 7, part 2 of 2. The king is distressed. He wants to save Daniel. Daniel 6:14. Then the king, when he heard these words, was sore displeased, and set his heart on Daniel to deliver him, and he labored until the going down of the sun to rescue him. But even the king could not change his own law, as was the way of the Medo-Persians. Daniel 6:15. Then these men assembled together to the king and said to the king, "Know, O king, that it is the law of the Medes and Persians that no interdict or statute which the king establishes may be changed." Daniel was thrown into the lion's den, while the king expressed hope that God would rescue Daniel. Daniel 6:16-17. Then the king commanded, and they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spoke and said to Daniel, "Your God, whom you serve continually, will deliver you." A stone was brought and laid on the mouth of the den, and the king sealed it with his own signet, and with the signet of his lords, that nothing might be changed concerning Daniel. The king is overjoyed that Daniel is safe. He is not very happy with those who accused Daniel. In fact, he was so distressed he was not able to sleep. Daniel 6:18. Then the king went to his palace and passed the night fasting. Neither were instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep fled from him. Darius was up at first light. Daniel 6:19. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste to the den of lions. He went to see if Daniel was still alive. Daniel 6:20-21. When he came near to the den to Daniel, he cried with a lamented voice. The king spoke and said to Daniel, "Daniel, servant of the living God, is your God, whom you serve, continually able to deliver you from the lions?" Then said Daniel to the king, "O king, live forever." God had sent an angel to keep Daniel safe. Daniel 6:22-23. My God has sent his angel and has shut the lions' mouths, and they have not hurt me, because as before him innocence was found in me, and also before you, O king, I have done no hurt. Then was the king exceedingly glad, and he commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found on him, because he had trusted in his God. The governors and administrators who had accused Daniel were thrown to the lions. They did not fare so well. Daniel 6:24. The king commanded, and they brought those men who had accused Daniel, and they cast them into the den of lions, them, their children, and their wives. And the lions had the mastery of them, and broke all of their bones in pieces before they came to the bottom of the den. Darius is so amazed, he sends a decree throughout the kingdom. Daniel 6:25. Then the king Darius wrote to all the peoples, nations, and languages who dwell in all the earth, "Peace be multiplied to you." In the decree he glorified the God of heaven and ordered everyone to fear and reverence him. Daniel 6:26-27. I make a decree that in all the dominion of my kingdom men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel, for he is the living God and steadfast forever. His kingdom, that which shall not be destroyed, and his dominion shall be even to the end. He delivers and rescues, and he works signs and wonders in heaven and in earth. Who has delivered Daniel from the power of the lions? Daniel prospers during the reign of Darius and Cyrus the Persian. Daniel 6:28. So this Daniel prospered in the reign of Darius and in the reign of Cyrus the Persian. The end of Daniel 6, Lesson 7, Part 2. Part 2 of 2.